Undertaker for a long, long time.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Paul Bearer.
And you have to wonder what Paul Bearer is about to say. What effect will it have on The Undertaker this Sunday on pay-per-view?
Who is this idiot?
There's some fans.
They're having a problem here.
Some lady.
See, you think those fans don't deserve to be slugged?
Well, we get some security out here.
Easy. Mr. Bearer.
That's one of the creatures of the night, I would assume.
I'd like to remind you, Paul Bearer, that The Undertaker is here with us tonight. And he, along with millions of others, will be listening to every word you say.
Well, we're going to have to go back a few years, Mr. McMahon. About 20 years, to be exact. We're talking about a little funeral home sitting up on a hill, beautiful oak trees all around, and a wonderful, wonderful family-owned funeral home. The family lived upstairs. The father was the mortician who ran the funeral home. The mother was the secretary, the receptionist. But there were two little kids there. One kid was a little red-headed punk. And then there was a second kid, a sweet little kid, named Kane. Now, I was the apprentice at the funeral home. I worked under the red-headed punk's father, who by now you probably know is The Undertaker. The Undertaker's father was a mortician of excellence. He taught me everything I know. He taught me the correct way to prepare a body for burial, how to do the makeup, how to deal with the families. He taught me from A to Z. But while I was working at that funeral home, I seen a lot of things going on that shouldn't have been happening. This little red-headed punk, there was something funny about him. He had a look in his eyes. The look of the devil. He was the devil's seed, if you know what I mean. What was so sad about the whole situation is that poor little Kane, the little brother, followed the Undertaker around everywhere he went. The Undertaker was little Kane's hero. Anything the Undertaker did was fine. Well, it went on for about 2 years, my apprenticeship. I was going to college at night, taking courses in mortuary science at the same time. The Undertaker and Kane would run around the funeral home like wild men. They had free reign of the property. They'd sneak out behind the garage. I see what they were doing. Their mom and daddy didn't see what they were doing, but I saw what they were doing. I saw them taking chemicals out of the embalming room of the funeral home. I saw them sneaking behind the garage, smoking cigarettes when they were little kids. But you know, one particular afternoon, I was leaving to go to school. As I backed my car out of the funeral home, I looked behind, and who do I see? That red-head devil seed Undertaker with his little brother. Something was funny. Something didn't seem right. But I went ahead and backed out of the driveway, went to school. I came back from school about 10 o'clock that night, and what do I see? I see fire trucks. I see ambulances. I see steam and smoke. And I see the funeral home in ashes. Someone burned down the funeral home. Inside the funeral home was this lovely family that took care of me. I looked over to the bushes. Who did I see in the bushes but The Undertaker? Undertaker, you burnt the funeral home to the ground. And along with the funeral home, you killed your parents. You killed your family, Undertaker. I know it. I've had this secret on my inside all my life, 20 years. You killed them. Undertaker, you are a murderer.